So last week in the last video, I talked about what I believe is the best, fastest service to go from zero to 10K or more per month with an online service-based business, right? Whether you're a freelancer or a drop service agency or an SMMA, whatever you are, if you're delivering services online, I think that email copywriting, email marketing is the most valuable and the fastest service to offer to go from zero to 10K per month or more, especially right now. And so if you haven't watched that video, go back and watch that first, because I talked about how we're rebuilding our agency growth response around that as our core service offering. And in this video, I'm gonna talk about the exact steps that we're gonna take to go out and relaunch and rebuild the agency from basically from scratch, right? So if you haven't watched last week's video first, go watch that. It's gonna make a lot more sense when you watch this video if you've seen that one already. And I'm gonna jump into these different steps right now. I'm gonna talk to you about what we're working on and show you examples where I can, and then give you an idea of how we look at business, right? How we think about starting and scaling our business, and how we're gonna be going out to get clients for this new niche, this new service, okay? So first thing, let's talk about the niche here. Who are we going to be targeting with our service? At least in the beginning, who are we focusing on? So the niche is the info product and e-learning space, right? Anyone who, they could be selling e-learning software to help people learn, right? To sell education. And then also anyone who is selling education, right? Could be ebooks, could be video training, could be courses, coaching, consulting programs. Anyone who sells information or education online, right? So why did I pick this niche? Well, one of my businesses, right, is in the info product space. So I understand this space. I'm passionate about it. I sell info products of my own. So I understand it and I wanna learn and grow with this industry, right? So that's why I pick this niche, this market here. Now, the service that I'm gonna be offering, our core service is gonna be email automations and product launches, okay? And pay attention to this because this is a very important lesson. You always want to pick a service that makes sense for your niche, right? And I can't remember who asked or commented on my video. They said, how do I offer this service to this niche? I think it was like, how do I offer email marketing or something to the kitchen remodeling industry, okay? So what you really wanna be thinking, that's like the backwards way to think about it. You gotta go to the niche or the market first and ask yourself what their problem is that you, of course, wanna help to solve, and what service or offering is gonna help to best solve that, right? So a lot of people, they'll start with the service, I wanna offer Facebook ads, and they try to force it onto these industries where it doesn't make sense, right? So you always gotta start with the niche or the market first and figure out what service offering is gonna best solve the problem, the major problem or pain point for that niche, right? So being in the info product space myself, I know that email automations and product launch sequences are super important, right, for getting customers and making sales, right? And info product companies are launching new products all the time, right? New ebooks or new courses or training programs. And every time they do that, they need automation sequences and product launch sequences to help them increase their sales, right? Help them get more customers and clients for their new products and their new programs, okay? So the lesson again is to always start with the niche or the market first, figure out what their big problem is, and figure out what from there is the service that you can offer, the best service you can offer to help them solve that specific problem, right? So this is how I came upon the automations and product launches as our core service offering. Now, how are we gonna go out and get clients, right? What are the different strategies and tactics that we're gonna be using? So we already started using this first block here, right? Warm network. We started reaching out back in March to current and existing clients, right? People who are on our core LinkedIn prospecting and cold email prospecting service. We started reaching out to them, people we knew had bigger lists, and asked them, hey, are you monetizing your email list? Do you have these sequences set up for your business or for your SaaS company or whatever industry they're in? And if they didn't, we'd hop on a phone call, show them a demo of what we were thinking of rolling out, right? A beta offering. And we just offered it to them. We put a price tag on it, $3,500 per month. And then we offered it to some of our existing clients, right? And we got 5 clients for email marketing services, just talking to existing clients, right? And we're also, as of the last 2 weeks or so, starting to reach out to past clients who, for whatever reason, stopped working with us, right? Maybe they hired in-house. Maybe they were only doing a local campaign. Maybe they didn't need our services for a certain period because they had seasonal products or service offerings. So we're reaching out to some past clients that we have good relationships with still and asking them, hey, do you have an email list? Is this something you can benefit from? Are you interested in hopping on a quick phone call and letting us demo you how this could work for you? And we're reaching out to past clients, right? We're also reaching out to colleagues, mutual connections, And then also some of our service providers, right? So I buy mastermind programs, coaching programs. I buy different softwares, right? E-learning software as well. And I'm reaching out to these different service providers who might be able to benefit from our email marketing service, right? And just asking them the same thing. Hey, do you have an email list? Do you think you could benefit from a service like this? We have a beta offering where we wanna test this out before we roll it out to the public. How about we hop on a quick phone call, right? So very simple. And I'm always baffled by how people always skip the warm network, right? These are people who already know, like, and trust you for the most part, or who are already acquainted with you, right? They already know who you are. So you don't have to go out and try to pitch them cold. So always start with your warm network first. This is what we're doing right now. We've been doing this for the past few months, current existing clients, past clients, and then also colleagues, mutual connections, and even some service providers that might be able to benefit, people that were paying money that might be able to benefit from our service, okay? So that's still going on right now, but we're also starting LinkedIn. And what we're doing with LinkedIn is I'm doing three different things. Cold outreach, we're using a blanket approach where we just build lists in Sales Navigator, and then we're connecting with people, anyone who fits our ideal client profile. We're building a list of them on Sales Navigator, and we're just connecting with everybody, and we're messaging them, door knocking basically, and seeing if anyone wants to have a conversation, like a 15-minute phone call about how our service might be able to help them get more sales, okay? So basically what we're doing, again, is we're building a list of people on LinkedIn, and we're doing outreach by connecting and then sending them a message to try and generate an appointment. Now, what I'm also doing is something called account-based marketing and account-based sales. So if you follow Russell Brunson, who is the founder of ClickFunnels, he always talks about this concept called the Dream 100, where it's basically you build a list of 100 of you, of your dream customers, your dream companies, or clients that you'd want to work with. You build a list of these 100 companies and do some research on them. Where are they hanging out? What do they like? What interviews have they been on, or publications? And you make a list of all, you take detailed notes and do research on these 100 companies. And from there, you can do educated outreach, and it's a lot more manual than doing something just like the blanket approach with cold outreach. But for me, I built a list of these 100 companies that I want to work with that are in this niche here. And I've had my virtual assistants taking notes on these companies as they build a list, looking at where they're hanging out, publications, magazines, all that good stuff. And then I can shoot a quick Loom video, like a custom Loom video, you know, minute and a half, 2 minutes, and send it over to them through LinkedIn and through email as well, telling them about how we might be able to help them increase their sales, get more customers using email from their existing list. Okay, so that's what account-based is. It's more manual, it's more targeted, because you're doing research on these companies that would really be your dream customers, your dream clients, and you're reaching out to them with a more custom approach, okay? So there's the cold outreach blanket approach, where we're just building lists and doing, you know, basically blast outreach. And an account base, where we're doing more customized outreach, where I'm shooting videos for each of these 100 companies. Now, the third way is we're looking for companies who are hiring on LinkedIn for copywriting jobs. So let me just show you real quick what that looks like, all right? So I'm just gonna go here on LinkedIn. I'm gonna type in, here it is. Copywriter. So I just did in quotations, copywriter, and we're searching in the United States right now. And I'm gonna go here to all filters. And I'm just gonna target the, I'll just click internet here. And then also e-learning. And my virtual assistants, or one of them, is actually doing this for me right now. She's just building a list of all these different companies who fit our ideal client profile, who are hiring for copywriting jobs. So I'm just gonna click apply here. A quick note, I have Sales Navigator, so I don't know if this is gonna be available for you. This is on like the free platform right now, but I don't know if they just gave me some extra filters here, but that's just a quick note. If you don't see this, it's because I'm using a paid profile, but I'm gonna click apply here. You can see here, 293 results, right? These are 293 companies who are hiring for copywriters, right? Which is the service that we're offering. So one of my virtual assistants is building a list of all these companies in e-learning and basically any kind of internet or online business. And she's building a list of all these different copywriters, or these different companies here who are hiring for copywriters. And we can do outreach specifically to these companies, right? Say, hey, I saw that you're hiring for a copywriter. This is what we specialize in. This is what we can help you with. Are you interested in a quick chat, 15-minute chat or so in the next week? And we hop on the phone with them, show them how we can help them. and how we could probably save them money, because I'm guessing they're gonna be paying, you know, high five to six figure salaries to these copywriters here. And we're just reaching out to these companies here, anyone who's already hiring for a copywriter, right? Now, why do we do this? Well, it's obvious, or I hope it is. These companies are already looking for this, they're already looking and willing to pay for the service that we are offering, right? They're hiring for copywriters, and they're not gonna expect people to work for free. So my virtual assistant is making a list of these companies who already have buyer intent, right? They're looking to pay someone to do this. So this might be a good one too. Bold and Beyond. This looks like an e-commerce. This is an agency. Focuses on brands, right? Yeah, so there's tons of different companies here. 293 companies that are already hiring for copywriters. And I'm having lists built of these companies on LinkedIn, but also job boards like Monster, Angel.co. There's Indeed, and my virtual assistant's going through and making a list of all these companies that are hiring for copywriting jobs. And then we're gonna do outreach to those companies, okay? So that's a quick little hack that you guys, I don't know if you consider that a hack, it's more like a strategy, right? Look for companies that are already hiring for the job that you're gonna be offering. And you can do this for anything, right? Facebook ads, Google ads, if you're doing like social media management as well, or SEO, you can do the same strategy where you look for people who are already hiring for this job. Okay, and then do reach out to those specific companies. So that is the LinkedIn portion of things. Now we're also gonna be doing some reach out in Facebook groups and Instagram as well, but a lot of these e-learning companies and info product companies, a lot of them are on LinkedIn. So we're starting there first and then we'll branch out because, I mean, LinkedIn is like our bread and butter. That's what we know to do best. So we're starting off with our strong point and then we'll probably branch off to Facebook groups, Instagram later. So that is Warm Network and LinkedIn. Now, real quick, the sales process for this is after someone says, yes, I'd like to learn more, we take them straight to a call or a demo, right? Depending on how warm or hot they are, right? If someone's like, yes, I absolutely need to hire for this tomorrow, let's hop on a call, we might just do a demo right away, right? So LinkedIn, Warm Network, we're driving people to a call or a demo, right? Now, here is what may be a little different for you, like that you're seeing. You don't have to do this. This is specifically, we're doing this specifically because we want to demonstrate our services, email marketing and email copywriting. We want to demonstrate to people what that looks like, right? We want to show people what our emails are like, right? So we want to get people onto our email list. So how we're doing that is one strategy is paid advertising, right? So I love YouTube ads. We're using YouTube ads to drive people to a special report. I'm going to show you what that looks like in just a second. And from that special report, they get put onto our email list where they get to see my daily emails, right? So, and the daily emails are always selling them on booking a call and signing up for a done for you service, right? So paid advertising, YouTube ad to report to our email list where we continue to send emails every day and demonstrate to them how our email copy is. And if they like that, they're gonna see firsthand what that's gonna look like if we were to offer it as a service for them. They book a call with us and then sign up for a service. Right, so that's paid advertising. That's one extra strategy that we're using. And then also inbound. So I'm gonna be doing things like writing articles on email marketing. I'm gonna try and get some podcast interviews where I share what I know, you know, tips, tricks, strategies, insights on email marketing, email copywriting on different podcasts that serve my audience, right? Serve my target market. And then also, I wanna be doing social selling posts. So as I'm growing my LinkedIn network and as I'm growing my Facebook profile, I'm gonna start to post tips, tricks, and insights, social media posts on places like Facebook and LinkedIn. And what that's gonna do is get people to come to me, right? That's what inbound is. So as I'm writing these articles, I'm doing these interviews and podcasts, and I'm writing out social selling posts on Facebook and LinkedIn, and people are gonna see it who are in my target market because I'm gonna be connecting with those people. That's gonna get people to reach out to me, right? So we have methods over here like outbound, warm, LinkedIn, and then I have inbound methods like paid advertising and inbound. And these paid ads and inbound strategies are leading people to our email list so that we can demonstrate to them what it looks like to work with us, right? Now, once they're on our email list, we're gonna sell them on the call or the demo, right? We're gonna tell them why they should hop on a phone call with us and why they could benefit from our email marketing service, right? So very simple, right? We pick the niche, pick the service. We have different outreach methods, both outbound and inbound. And the outbound methods, we're driving them straight to a call or to a demo. And then from the inbound methods, we're driving them to an email list so we can demonstrate to them our email copy skills and then sell them on the call or the demo with us to sign up for a done for you service, right? And the last step is they become a client. Okay, so let me quickly show you what we've been working on. First, I've been spending the last week or so just working on our new website and setting up the different steps in this funnel here, okay? So this is our homepage. This is gonna be the new homepage. It's not live yet, but it's just a bunch of copy here. And it drives people to my email list, right? So it tells them they get the free subject line secrets report. This is what that looks like here. They opt in with their first name, their email address, which is this step here, right? They're gonna find me through written articles or an interview or some social selling posts that come to our website. They'll opt in for that free report. And once they opt in for this free report, they get taken to this page here. And this page is just like a 2 minute, I think this is like 2 or 3 minute VSL. And it just asks them, are you looking to scale your profits with an automated email sales machine? And from there, they can book a call, right, for a free 30-minute email Rainmaker session where I demo them our service and how it can work to help them get more sales in their business, right? So very simple funnel here. It's a two-step funnel. They go to our homepage here. They opt in for this report. They see this page. The thank you page is basically pitching them or selling them on booking a call for a done-for-you service. And we only take on 3 people a month for this because it is pretty work intensive. And if they say no to this or they X off this page, they're now on our email list where we can just send daily emails and show them what it would be like to work with us, right? What that email copy would actually look like to work with us and if we were to do it for them, right? So very simple funnel here. Everyone always likes to complicate it with these 10-step funnels. We have a 2-step funnel. And from there, it's all about just sending emails every day, right? Practicing our craft, getting better at that and showing them firsthand, demonstrating to them firsthand how we can actually help them and what our service is gonna look like for them, okay? So again, what we covered today, this is basically how we're rebuilding. I'm gonna have to make more follow-up videos on how this looks like. I'm not sure if I'm gonna post that here on my YouTube channel or within my private mobile app or within with only for my accelerator students, haven't decided yet. But I want to give you a lay of the land on what we're gonna be working on at least for the next 6 months or so, right? This is how we're rebuilding, okay? We're targeting this specific niche. We're offering the specific service. We've already started reaching out to a warm network. We've started doing LinkedIn. We're gonna start to launch the paid ads and inbound stuff within the next week or so. And we're driving people to both our email list and straight to a call. And eventually they become a client with us if they see that we can actually help them with their service, right? So this is it. This is the big picture right here. This is how we are rebuilding. It's simple on purpose. You guys know that I love simple. And these are the steps that we're taking, right? We're gonna be focusing on doing all this warm network, the LinkedIn outreach, paid advertising and inbound, like things like writing articles, emails, podcast interviews, social selling posts. This is what we're focusing on for the next 6 months as we rebuild this company and this agency, right? The goal is to get this to anywhere from 80K to 100K per month by the end of the year. Will we get there? I don't know. It would be amazing if we did, but I'm mapping out the steps here that we're taking to get there, okay? So hope you guys enjoyed this, seeing a bird's eye view, seeing kind of how I think and how I look at business and how we rebuild things or start from scratch basically, and how we're rebuilding Growth Response, which is my agency, and focusing more on email marketing, email copywriting as our core service, okay? So that's it for this video. If you guys like this, give me a like, give me a thumbs up, comment below with any questions, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.